Let's start the poem, A Thing of Beauty, written by John Keats. Anyone who can explain the idea that is... Yes, anyone who can explain the idea that is clear from the title of the poem, A Thing of Beauty? And you might have heard this proverb saying of John Keats, A Thing of Beauty is a joy forever, the very first line of your poem. Anyone who can explain the idea given in this? It's a very oft repeated line, not a new line for you. You might have heard it already. Yes, quickly come forward. Would like to share the views? No one? You have never heard this line? Yes, Gurveer Kaur?
Ma'am, this may be referring to some beautiful view of nature. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Have you ever heard this quote? Suna pehle kabhi ye line, A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Yes. No one? इसने नहीं सुनी ये लाइन जैस्मीन एनी आइडिया
नो मैम
नो इट्स वेरी ऑफ्ट रिपीटेड लाइन एंड यू माइट हैव हर्ड दिस लाइन मेनी टाइम्स एंड एज यू कैन सी द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी And if we relate it with the first line of your poem, A Thing of Beauty is a joy forever. What does it suggest? That the beautiful things of nature, which God has provided us as free gifts, they always give us joy, happiness. And that happiness is everlasting. Forever means everlasting. It never comes to an end. You imagine any scene, beautiful scene, which you have viewed sometimes. Imagine that you went for a picnic. ठीक है आप कहीं picnic पर गए वहाँ आपने beautiful scenery देखी कोई nature की कोई mountains की आपको picture अच्छी लगी कोई आप natural scene आपको sky का scene कोई अच्छा लगता है वहाँ mountains area में valleys में जब आप जाते हो you click the pictures. Because you feel happy about those beautiful scenes. And when you come back after a few days or after a few months or years, or the picture is of your childhood and in your young age, you open your albums and now in your mobiles, you see those pictures, you feel happy. Once again, you enjoy that beauty. Looking at those pictures and it gives you a lot of pleasure. You feel happy about those moments which you spend in that valley or in the mountainous area or in any hotel where you clicked your pictures. And when you remember those times, you feel very happy. And it gives you great pleasure, happiness. That never comes to an end. Forever means कभी भी वो खत्म नहीं होती हमेशा आपके मन में वो खुशी जो है हमेशा बनी रहती है Whenever you look at those pictures of those beautiful things. This is general example of our life. But in reality, when we go outside, we see any beautiful flower, we see any beautiful scene, ठीक है या नेचर में कई बार आप ऊपर अपने घर की छत पर जाते हो आकाश में आपको बहुत अच्छा सीन नजर आता है जैसे पीछे बहुत शोर मचा था कि हमारा एनवायरनमेंट जो है वो पोल्यूशन खत्म हो गई है बिकॉज पीपल आर लिविंग इनसाइड लॉकडाउन के अंदर तो वहाँ रेनबो नजर आ रहे थे लोगों को आकाश के अंदर एंड वी फील हैप्पी विद दोज ब्यूटिफुल सीन्स ऑफ नेचर सो दिस इज द आइडिया विच द पोएट वॉन्ट्स टू कन्वे इन दिस पोएम अबाउट द प्लेयर्स The happiness that is imparted to us by the beautiful things of nature and their timelessness. That means they are not bound to time. Forever, for all times, they give us pleasure. Now, if we read for the introduction about the poet, John Keats, his time period is 1795 to 1821, was a British romantic poet. Although trained to be a surgeon, Keats decided to devote himself wholly to poetry. Keats' secret, his power to sway and delight the readers, lies primarily in his gift for perceiving the world and living his moods and aspirations in terms of language. Uska secret kya hai ki he has the power to move the readers by giving his viewpoint about the world, about his moods, presenting all those things in the terms of his language. The Falling means this poem, A Thing of Beauty, is an excerpt, that means apart from his poem Endymion. There is a long poem, Endymion, from which this poem is taken, a poetic romance. The poem is based on a Greek legend. This poem, Endymion, which is a long poem, it is based on a Greek legend in which Endymion, a beautiful young shepherd and poet who lived on Mount Latmus, had a vision of Cynthia, the moon goddess. क्या बताया गया है उस पोएम में एक शेफर्ड है ब्यूटीफुल यंग शेफर्ड एंड पोएट दे लिव्ड ऑन द माउंट लेटमस एंड दे हैड अ विजन ऑफ सिंथिया सिंथिया इज रेफर्ड टू द मून गॉडेस द एन्चांटेड यूथ रिजॉल्व टू सीक हर आउट एंड सो वांडर्ड अवे थ्रू द फॉरेस्ट एंड डाउन अंडर द सी और उसको ढूंढने के लिए दे वांडर्ड हियर एंड देयर in the forest and under the sea. But in this poem, which is apart from that long poem of Endymion, the poet has just praised the beauty of nature. It says, what pleasure does a beautiful thing give us? Are beautiful things worth fearing? Yes, of course. As I have discussed with you the example of the pics, when we take of the beautiful things, beautiful scenes of nature, we preserve them. You keep those photographs in the form of album, or nowadays we have in our mobiles a large number of photographs which we keep as our memory whenever we go anywhere. So the beautiful things of nature, they give us pleasure, they give us happiness, and we treasure them. We keep all those things as our memories safe with us forever. And whenever you are in sad mood, depressed mood, in dejected mood, you open those pictures and you start looking at those pics, beautiful scenes, and your mood changes. This is the idea which the poet has conveyed in this way. So look at the lines. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower white for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. In the very first line, the poet has praised the beauties of nature. He says, a thing of beauty is a joy for air. That the beautiful thing of nature that provides us beauty is a joy, is a source of joy for human beings forever. That means for whole life, we can get pleasure out of that. Its loveliness increases, and the beauty of those things, beauty of that beautiful thing of nature, increases with the passage of time. It will never pass into nothingness, means it will never come to an end. It never decreases, it always increases with the passage of time. जितनी बार आप उन पिक्चर्स को देखते हो खोलकर जितनी बार आप उन ब्यूटीफुल सीन्स को देखते हो यू गेट प्लेयर आउट ऑफ दैट इट नेवर कम्स टू एन एंड कभी भी खत्म नहीं होता डिक्रीज नहीं होता इट ऑलवेज इंक्रीजेज बट विल कीप अ बोर क्वाइट फॉर अस बोर हियर रेफर्स टू अ प्लेस ऑफ शेल्टर दैट ऑल दीज ब्यूटिफुल थिंग्स ऑफ नेचर और द ब्यूटिफुल सीन्स ऑफ नेचर दे प्रोवाइड अस अ शेल्टर quite from us. Quite for us means quite here refers to the silence. See the spelling, Q-U-I-E-T, quiet here refers to the silence. It gives us a very peaceful place and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. What is the result of all these beautiful things? When we see at these beautiful things, we preserve those beautiful scenes of nature. We get happiness out of that, which increases with the passage of time. It never comes to an end. And it provides us a shelter, a quiet shelter. That means a peaceful place, a peace of mind. When we look at those things, we feel happy and we get peace out of that. And a sleep. What is the result of all these beautiful things? We get a good sleep, because when we are happy, when we are peaceful at our mind, we don't have any tension and stress, we get good sleep. That is full of sweet dreams. We have good dreams, sweet dreams in our sleep. And automatically when we get good sleep, it will lead to good health and quiet breathing. Breathing, that means our breathing system will improve. We'll have quiet breathing. सांस लेते हुए हमारी आवाज नहीं आएगी. दैट मीन्स साइलेंस ब्रीदिंग. आपकी है ना, जब कोई सांस की प्रॉब्लम है तो आप सांस लेते हो, या अंदर लंग्स में कोई प्रॉब्लम है तो जोर जोर से आवाजें आती हैं सांस लेने की. लेकिन यहाँ पर क्या वो बता रहा है कि इफ वी एंजॉय दीज ब्यूटीज ऑफ नेचर, वी गेट हैप्पीनेस, वी गेट पीस, वी गेट गुड स्लीप फुल ऑफ स्वीट ड्रीम्स, एंड ऑटोमेटिकली आवर हेल्थ इंप्रूव्स. व्हेन वी गेट गुड स्लीप, हेल्थ इंप्रूव्स. We don't have any problem of our health, and we will have quiet breathing. Quiet here, again, see the spellings. Quiet refers to silence breathing, silent breathing. That means we will not have this noise of breathing. Saans lene ka shor nahi hoga. That means we'll have no problem of breathing. So in this way, we will have good health. Coming to the next stanza. Therefore, on every morrow, are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth, spite of despotence, of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways made for our searching. Till here the second stanza comes. So the line will, next stanza, third stanza will start from in between the line. So let's have the meaning of these lines. Therefore, that means this stanza is linked with the first stanza. What is told to us in the first stanza? That all the beautiful things of nature, they provide us pleasure, they give us happiness, which never comes to an end, which increases with the passage of time. And all those beautiful things of nature, when we enjoy those, we get the pleasure. It provides us a quiet shelter. It provides us a shelter or a peaceful place, which automatically gives us good sleep, good health, and good breathing system. So, therefore, here means, so on every mono, that is the reason. That means due to all these things which we get out of these beautiful things of nature, the pleasure and the happiness that we get, on every morrow, that means on every morning, we are weaving a flowery band to bind us to earth. We create a bond with the earth. When we get up in the morning, we look here and there around us. In all our surroundings, we see many beautiful things of nature. We see flowers, we see plants, trees, air, sky, clouds, sun, moon, all these things. When we look at all these things, that creates a bond of the human beings with the earth. So what the poet says, that due to all these benefits that we get through the beautiful things of nature, on every morning, morrow here refers to morning, on every morning, we create a flowery band. Flowery band means a happy band, a good bond of relationship with the earth. Human beings create a good bond, relation with the earth, looking at all the things which are around us, which surround us, the beautiful things of nature, which gives us pleasure. Spite of despotence. In spite of the despotence, despotence means the sad mood, the depression or the stress that we have in our life. Yes, Gurveer beta, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, your voice is cracking in between.
Okay. maybe some network issue. It's not clear totally.
No, ma'am, it's skipping some words okay, in between okay, when okay. you explain.
Okay. First stanza is clear. Yes, the second stanza we have started that.
Ma'am, please repeat the last lines.
Full of sweet dreams and health, quiet breathing. So this is the effect of the beautiful things of nature given, that when we enjoy the beauties of nature, we get good health, good sleep, which automatically gives us good sweet dreams that improves our health. And we have quiet breathing. That means there is no problem of breathing in our health. So that's why the poet says that every morning we create a bond with the earth. We look at the beautiful things of nature and automatically a flowery band. Flowery band here refers to the relation of the human beings that is created by looking at the beautiful things of nature. We have a bond with the earth. और वो bond कैसे बनता है हमारा जब हम इन सारी चीजों को देखते हैं and we feel happy about that. We get pleasure out of that. Then a bond is created which is called as a flowery band. Flower refers to the beauty of nature. Spite of despondence, of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching. The poet says that in spite of the despondence here refers to the stress, the tensions, the worries or the depression that we get out of those, because we human beings, a modern man, is full of worries and tensions. We are always running for the mad race of money, and when we don't reach to our destination, we don't get our goals, we don't get success in our goals, we feel sad and we become depressed. But the poet says that in spite of the despondence, in spite of that sadness or the depression, of the inhuman dearth, we human beings have dearth. Dearth means a lack of human qualities. Of the inhuman dearth, we people lack the human qualities. Inhuman qualities hum logo ne apne mind mein create kar li hain. That means we are not working for the welfare of the humanity. We are not thinking about others. So we lack these humane qualities, achhi qualities, jisko kehte hain ki dusron ke bare mein sochna, dusron ki bhalai ke bare mein sochna. Agar dusra koi dukhi hai to uske dukh mein uske sath dukh ke shamil hona ya uski help karna needy ya poor logon ki. So we are creating in ourselves inhuman qualities. Loot maar kar liya, dhokha kar liya dusron ke sath, chori chakari kar li. और जो हमें चाहिए वो हमें हासिल हो जाना चाहिए, चाहे किसी भी तरीके से हम गलत मेथड से अडॉप्ट करें. सो वी आर हैविंग इनह्यूमन क्वालिटीज. डर्थ मीन्स अ लैक, कमी है हम लोगों में ह्यूमन क्वालिटीज की. ऑफ नोबल नेचर, वी डोंट हैव नोबल नेचर, वी डोंट हैव गुड नेचर्स. हमारी नेचर जो है कैसी है, फुल ऑफ जेलेसी, एनिमिटी फॉर अदर्स. कि हमारे पास चीज नहीं है, वी फील जेलेसी ऑफ अदर्स, दोज हु पजेस दोज थिंग्स. कि हमारे फ्रेंड के पास है, हमारे पड़ोसियों के पास है, हमारे पास क्यों नहीं है. वी हैव जेलेसी. सो वी आर नॉट ऑफ नोबल नेचर. ऑफ द ग्लूमी डेज एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स क्रिएट ग्लूमी डेज. ग्लूमी डेज मीन्स द सैड डेज, बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग इनह्यूमन क्वालिटीज. वी लैक ह्यूमन क्वालिटीज, वी लैक नोबल नेचर. दैट्स वाई आर डेज आर sad. Our life is sad. Gloomy means very serious, very, very sad, because we are not satisfied with our life, we are not happy in our life. Of all unhealthy and over darkened ways, we are adopting all unhealthy ways. Unhealthy ways, that means which are causing problem to our health. Hum sare galat tareeke apna rahe hain. We are sitting continuously, we are not doing any exercise, we are doing wrong actions to get the money. All over darkened ways means ill ways, wrong method adopt kar rahe hum, which are causing effect on our health. When we are not satisfied, we have the feeling of jealousy for others, we have enmity for others, what will happen? It will create tensions and worries. So we are causing problem to our own health. The poet says that in spite of all this made for our searching, we search for our happiness. मतलब इन सब के बावजूद भी हम अपनी खुशी ढूंढते हैं और वो खुशी हमें कहाँ से मिलेगी, कहीं से नहीं मिलेगी. Because we avoid looking at the beautiful things of nature. Here the poet wants to give us to give time to nature. We must spend some time in the company of nature, because we people, that means the human beings, modern man, is full of sadness, full of depression, and this depression is due to our inhuman ways, inhuman methods which we adopt to get more and more facilities, to get more and more privilege, to get more and more money. We are lacking in human qualities. We don't have good and noble nature. That's why our days are sad. We adopt ill ways, dark ways, means wrong methods, which are causing effect to our health. So we are becoming unhealthy. ये सारी health की problem आप देख रहे हैं, किसी को BP है, किसी को heart की problem है, किसी को कोई problem है, तो ये सारी problems कहाँ से create हो रही हैं? Due to the tensions and the worries. And tension और worry हमें आजकल किस चीज़ की है? Modern man को किस चीज़ की है? To get more and more money, to get more and more things and privileges, and the feeling of jealousy that we have for others, कि हमारे पास नहीं है, हमारे friends के पास है, हमारे पड़ोसियों के पास है, हमारे relatives के पास है, तो वी फील जेलिस, जिससे क्या होता है, वी आर अंडर टेंशन. और वो टेंशन और वरी क्या देती है हमें? इल हेल्थ, अनहेल्दी, वी बिकम अनहेल्दी. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर क्रिएटेड बाय द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, बट अगेन वी सर्च फॉर हैप्पीनेस. बट द पोएट सेज देयर इज अ सॉल्यूशन. कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट लाइंस, ही सेज यस, इन स्पाइट ऑफ ऑल सम शेप ऑफ ब्यूटी मूव्स अवे द पॉल from our dark spirits. Lekin phir bhi kya keh raha hai poet, ki in spite of all these problems which we are creating for our health due to our bad ways, due to dark ways, the wrong methods that we adopt in our life to earn money, we deceive others, we cheat others. Even two brothers, they are fighting and killing and murdering each other for the property. So all these things, in spite of all these things, the poet says, some shape of beauty moves away the pall. Pall here refers to the sadness. Some shape of beauty, some beautiful things of nature, they can move away the pall, they can move away the sadness from our mind, from our dark spirits. Hamari spirits jo ki dark ho chuki hain. Dark here refers to the ill feelings that we have in our mind for others. Hamare mind mein dusron ke liye galat feelings hain. Hum kabhi bhi dusre ka acha nahi sochte. हमें लगता है कि हमें किस चीज़ में फ़ायदा है, हम वो काम करेंगे, चाहे उससे हमें दूसरे का मर्डर ना करना पड़ जाए, या किसी को मारना ना पड़ जाए, या धोखा करना पड़े, या चोरी करनी पड़े. वी आर रेडी फॉर ऑल दीज थिंग्स जस्ट टू मेक आर सेल्व्स हैप्पी एंड टू गेट मोर एंड मोर वेल्थ, टू गेट मोर एंड मोर पोजिशंस एंड थिंग्स इन लाइफ, मोर एंड मोर प्रिविलेजेस. सो वी आर अडॉप्टिंग रॉन्ग मेथड्स. बट द पोएट सेज still there is some solution to come out of that sadness which is being caused due to all these problems, due to all these ill wills and depressions and sadness. How can we come out? By looking at the beautiful things of nature. We can remove the pall. Pall here refers to the sadness from our dark spirits, from our bad spirits, from our ill spirits, the ill feelings that we have in our mind. Coming to the next stanza, in which the poet has referred to all those beautiful things which can bring us out of this sadness, such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon. For simple sheep, and such are daffodils, with the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make, against the hot season, the mid-forest brake, rich with the sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms. Till here, the poet has mentioned all the beautiful things of nature which provide us happiness. The poet has mentioned about the sun, which provides heat and light to all equally. The moon, again, which gives us peace, coolness, and the light. Trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon. All the trees, whether they are old and young, tall and short, they provide us, they give a shady boon. Shady boon means a shady place, which gives us shelter, comfortable, peaceful place. For simple sheep, all these trees, this is referred to, this is linked with the previous line, that all the old, young, the tall and the short, they all these trees, they provide a shady place, a comfortable place for the simple sheep. Sheep here refers to the innocent human beings and to the beast, to the animals. It refers to both. So we get shelter, the human beings as well as the animals, they all get shelter under the shady place of the comfortable and peaceful place of the trees. Such are daffodils with the green world they live in. Then we have the beauty of the daffodil flowers, the yellow daffodil flowers, which provide beauty to the green world. The green world here refers to the forest they live in. That means daffodil flowers which bloom in the forest, they provide beauty to that area where they live. That means to that particular forest, to that particular area where these daffodil flowers bloom. And clear rills that for themselves a cooling cupboard make against the hot season. Clear rills, rills here refer to the small streams of water. Pani ke chote chote chashme hote hain. Clear water, when it flows in the hot summer season, it creates a cooling place, cooling cupboard make. That means they make for themselves a cooling place. They provide cooling place to themselves also and to the human beings who go in that area of those rills. The mid forest brake, rich with the sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms. And in the mid of the forest, in the middle of the forest, rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose. Fair musk rose, the white roses which bloom in the muddy area. Musk here, in the muddy area, white roses which bloom in that area, that they sprinkle their beauty. And rich with the sprinkling means they enrich that area with sprinkling their beauty, providing their beauty to that area. So in this way, the poet has mentioned all the beautiful things of nature which provide beauty to all the atmosphere or to the environment, and we can get pleasure out of that and come out of the sadness which is created by ourselves, by our wrong actions, by our wrong deeds. So to come out of that sadness, nature is the best source. The poet wants to say this idea through these lines. We'll continue with the poem tomorrow.